Welcome to a lesson on Bayes' theorem. Bayes' theorem, also known as Bayes' rule or Bayes' law, is given here for the probability of A given B. But before we apply Bayes' theorem, let's look at an example of conditional probability and solve it intuitively, and then see if we get the same results using Bayes' theorem. A certain virus infects one in every 400 people. A test used to detect the virus in a person is positive 85% of the time if the person has the virus, and 5% of the time if the person does not have the virus. This 5% is called the false positive, because they test positive but don't have the virus. We'll let A be the event the person has the virus, and B be the event the person tests positive for the virus. A, we want to find the probability that a person has the virus given that they have tested positive, meaning the probability of A given B. B, we want to find the probability that a person does not have the virus given that they tested negative, meaning the probability of not A given not B. Let's organize the information in a table. Looking at this first column, if A is the event they have the virus, then not A would be when they don't have the virus, and if B is when they test positive, not B would mean they test negative. To help us complete this table, let's look at an example where we consider 10,000 people as a sample. If the virus infects one in every 400 people, the probability of A is equal to 1 divided by 400, or 0.0025. So to determine how many of these 10,000 people would actually have the virus, we'll find the product of 10,000 and 0.0025. So 10,000 times 0.0025 tells us that of the 10,000 people, 25 would be infected with the virus, which means this row here must have a total of 25, and then 10,000 minus 25, or 9,975, would be the number of people that don't have the virus. Next, the person is positive 85% of the time if the person has the virus. So of these 25 people, 85% of them would test positive, so we can say the probability of B given A is equal to 85%, or 0.85. Again, this is the probability the person tests positive given they have the virus. So let's find 85% of 25, which would go in this cell here. So 25 times 0.85. I know we can't have a fraction of a person, but for our theoretical probability, let's go ahead and put in 21.25 for the number of people that have the virus and test positive. Which means the difference of 25 and 21.25 would be the number of people that have the virus and test negative. 25 minus 21.25 is 3.75. Next, 5% of those that test positive don't have the virus, which means the probability of B given not A equals 5%, or 0.05. Again, this is the probability of testing positive given they don't have the virus. So 5% of these people here will test positive even though they don't have the virus. So let's find 5% of 9,975. This comes out to 498.75, which should be in this cell here. So the difference between 9,975 and this value would be the number of people that don't have the virus and test negative. So 9,975 minus 498.75 is equal to 9,476.25. If we find the sum of this column here, we get 520. This is the number of people that test positive for the virus. The total of this column here is 9,480. This is the number of people that would test negative. Notice how this row and this column both total 10,000, which is the number of people we're considering. Now from this table, we should be able to find the conditional probabilities that we were asked to find. To find the probability of A given B, or the probability of having the virus given they test positive, well, 520 people out of the 10,000 test positive, and 21.25 actually have the virus. So 21.25 divided by 520 will give us the probability of A given B. We'll calculate this in just a moment. Let's first find the probability not A given not B. Well, total number of people that tested negative is 9,480. Of those, 9,476.25 would be not A, meaning don't have the virus. So the probability of not A given not B would be equal to this quotient. To save some time, I've already found these values, which are here. So the probability of A given B would be approximately 0.0409, or approximately 4.09%. This value should be quite surprising. This means only 4.09% of the people that test positive actually have the virus, which means hopefully there's a better test to determine who's infected with the virus. The probability of not A given not B, meaning the probability a person doesn't have a disease given they tested negative, is approximately 99.96%, which actually is good. So this test is pretty good for determining who doesn't have the disease, but it's not very good for determining who does have the disease. Now let's go back to Bayes' theorem and verify this first conditional probability. Again, here's Bayes' theorem from an earlier slide. And from our problem, the given information was the probability of A is equal to 0.0025. The probability not A is equal to 0.9975. The probability of B given A was 0.85. And the probability of B given not A was 0.05. So if we take these values and sub them into Bayes' theorem, which we see here, if we simplify this, we do get the same result that we found from our table, where probability of A given B is approximately 0.0409, or 4.09%. But I think a lot of times, it'll be easier to use our intuition to find these conditional probabilities rather than memorize Bayes' theorem. I hope you found this explanation helpful.